We're about to start another Ashes. How the preparations been going?
They've gone really well. We've had about 6 weeks now playing really good boys teams from different counties, and they've prepared us really well. We've had to play some really tough cricket, and we've learned a lot about ourselves and about our brand, and it's going really well, so we're looking forward to it.
You mentioned the word there, brand. Is this the same kind of thing we see from the men now? They're more attacking kind of cricket, is that the plan?
Yeah, I mean, we've been working on it for a while now, probably before the men started to come out from them, but it's just basically being really positive, having fun, enjoying yourself, playing with freedom, and not, you know, thinking about anything but what you're in the game, and having your game plan and hitting to your strengths. So we're really confident that this is, you know, the new start of something really good, and we're really looking forward to putting it in place come Tuesday.
Fully ready to come storming in come Tuesday?
I hope so, yeah. I mean, I feel really good. I'm in good nick, and it's been about 3 years coming since I've played without pain, so my back's really good at the minute. I'm really strong and feeling in good rhythm, so hopefully I can really dominate with the ball up front alongside Anya Shrubsall and Kate Cross. So we hope to take really early wickets and getting right in there from the start, so I'm really looking forward to it, yeah.
When you know you're suffering with that back, you get up in the morning, the back's hurting, and you know that in a few weeks' time you're going to be on TV in a massive series that's going to have a huge international global audience. Does that make getting fit just slightly easier?
Well, you just made me feel quite nervous now. No. I mean, this is a massive series, isn't it? And it seems to just be more emphasis on it every year, and it seems to get bigger every year. And this year, every ball is going to be televised and on radio, and you know, everybody's looking at what you're doing. So you have more and more reason to improve your game year on year, and you always want to be better. I mean, the moment you don't want to be better is the moment you should probably think about stopping what you're doing. So we always want to be fitter, stronger, and better at our skills. And what better place to do it than at the Ashes?
England have won the last two Ashes, but it's Australia who hold the World Cup. They go into this possibly favourites, or is it England who start as favourites, as holders?
Well, T20 World Cups, T20 World Cups, or any tournament involving T20s, it can, you know, the whole thing can change, the whole game can change in an over. You can take three quick wickets and that's the end of that. And so, I mean, you can dominate quite a lot in those tournaments just by being good at what you do, but they can change for anyone. As you saw, we lost our opening round to Sri Lanka, and that was a big blow for us. So I guess on that front, you can't really say that they'll dominate in this form of the game, where it's skills all round in the long formats and the short formats. So we're very confident having won the last two series, and I guess we're on top going into it.
Of course, the way this Ashes works with the points, 4 points for the test match, 2 points for the 3 1-days and 3 2020, just evens it all out nicely as well and makes every game so competitive.
Yeah, to be honest, the last couple of times it's been pretty scary going into a test match thinking that you could be so far behind having lost 6 points. So it will make that game a lot more interesting. I think people will play more positively, a bit more freedom, because there's not so much riding on it. You know, you could win or lose the Ashes on one test match before, and so now it just makes it more interesting, especially with it being televised this year. So it's going to be interesting. Every game will have something riding on it, and no doubt with the two teams that are playing, it'll go all the way to the end.
You played a bit at Taunton before, so do you think that's an advantage for England that this was a women's base?
Yeah, I mean, we know this ground very well. It's not changed much, apart from a bit of scenery. But yeah, the crowd here are always brilliant. They always get behind us 100%, and we love batting on it. I don't like bowling. but we've got our plans in place, and I think we'll know how to play best on this wicket come the first game, so we're pretty confident heading into it.